great can
be. Just want you to believe God and know that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think.
Break every
chain. He said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, glory to God to stand. So what God has anointed his people to do, we as Christians, we as believers, we are called to bind the activity of Satan and to set the captives free. Glory to God.
Praise the Lord. God bless you today. Thank you for tuning in to Setting the Captives Free broadcast. I am your host, Evangelist Savannah Spears, and as always, I'm excited about the Word of God. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I just thank God for another day. I thank Him for another opportunity. Thank God today for all the snow. We thank Him today for the sun that shines, the birds that sing. We give God all the praise, the honor, and the glory because He is truly in control of it all. So we thank Him today. Glory to God. I thank God for His word. When it comes to the word of God, I'm just excited for an opportunity to share the word of God. Glory to God. And we can see the condition of the world today and the things that are going on around us. We can see that Jesus is soon to come. Our souls should be grieved over the condition of our nation, the condition of the people and the leaders of our nation, just the condition of the church today. Our souls, our very souls should be grieved to the point where it motivates us to pray. Amen. It motivates us to want to do better. It motivates us to want to walk in obedience to the word of God. Glory to God. So before we get off into a long discussion about what's going on in the world today, we just want to go to the throne room and thank God that it could be so much worse. Amen. We thank God for what it is, and that it's not any worse than it is, because it's going to get worse before it get better. But I just pray to God that before it get worse, that we will have developed a relationship with God through prayer. Before it get worse, we will know how to use the weapons of our warfare to fight and combat the enemy. Before it get worse, we will be prepared, glory to God, to use the weapons of our warfare and fight the enemy. Amen. So with that said, we just thank God today. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord God, for this day. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give your glory, God, because we know that you're worthy. There's no God like you nowhere. There is no other God. We praise your holy name. We bless your holy name today, Father God. And we come before you right now, Father, asking forgiveness for all of our sins, the sins of omission, the sins of commission, anything, Father God, that we've said, done, thought, or desired that was contrary to your word. We ask forgiveness, Lord God. We repent of those sins right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And we ask you, Father God, to wash us and cleanse us in the blood of your dear son, Jesus. And Father, we forgive everyone this morning, this afternoon, who have wronged us, who have offended us, who have disappointed us, who have hurt us. God, we release those individuals into your hands. For your word says, vengeance is yours and you will repay. So we forgive them. We release them, Father God. We free them up so that we can be free. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you today, Lord God, for the power of forgiveness in Jesus' name. And Father, we lift up those today who are less fortunate than we are. We lift up those, Father God, mothers and families who are grieving today over the loss of loved ones. Father, we lift them up right now. And we ask, Father God, that you release your peace upon them, the peace that surpasses all understanding, the peace that will keep their hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. We're asking you, Father God, to heal them. Heal their brokenness this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you, Father. We ask this morning, Father God, that you would intervene on behalf of the victims of the storms, the tornadoes, the earthquake, the tsunamis, oh God, the fires and the violence this morning. We ask this morning for divine intervention, Father God. We ask for divine restoration this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. God, that you will restore that which was lost in Jesus' name. We ask, Father God, that you would just intervene, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Father. We praise you today that you are still God. In the midst of it all, you are still God. We thank you today, Father God, for saving sinners everywhere, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, we realize, Father God, that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. We pray today that the Lord of the harvest would thrust the perfect laborer into the path of every sinner, man, woman, boy, and girl, to minister the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ in such a manner they will stop and listen, recognize their need for a Savior, and begin to cry out, "What must I do? What must I do to be saved?" And God, the interest of your word will shed light to this lost and dying world. I thank you today, Father, in Jesus' name, for saving, healing, and deliverance. Help us to realize today, Father, that Jesus came to set the captives free. So, Father God, we accept and we appropriate by faith everything that your son Jesus did for us on the cross of Calvary over 2,000 years ago. We accept it and receive it by faith this day in Jesus' name. We thank you and we praise you. Now, Father God, I pray today and I ask that you anoint me, Father, to bring your word today in the mighty name of Jesus. I realize, Lord God, that without you, I can do nothing. So I step back as you step forth, Holy Spirit, and impart this word within the lives of your people, that we will be doers of your word and not just hearers only. In Jesus' name, amen. I thank God today for the power of prayer. I thank God that he's still here and answers prayer. The Bible tells us that the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open unto their cry. So I thank God today that he's still a prayer answering God. Glory to God. I thank God today that prayer still changed things. Prayer still changed people. So no matter what you are going through today, don't forget to pray. Don't forget to release and cast your cares upon the Lord, for he cares for you. Cast your burdens upon the Lord. He will sustain you. He will never suffer the righteous to be moved. Let's thank God today for the power of prayer. Glory to God. Hallelujah. During the beginning of the year, in January, the first broadcast in January, I was admonishing the people to pray, to begin to pray more, to develop a prayer life. Because if there's ever anything that's going to get us through this last hour, it's going to be the power of prayer. And I mean sincere prayer, not this little 2 or 3 minute cosmetic prayer, but sincere prayer, glory to God, mixed with warfare. Glory to God. God tell us that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, through the pulling down of strongholds. And God has given us weapons to fight the enemy with. And I pray to God today that we learn how to use the weapons that God has given us. Amen. There are too many defeated saints. There are too many defeated Christians who are dying in battle, in this spiritual battle. We have to realize, people of God, that we are in a spiritual war, and we are fighting against unseen forces. And we are fighting with spiritual weapons. Glory to God. So I pray today, my prayer today is that we learn how to use the weapons that God has given us. And we begin to fight and combat the enemy with the weapons of our warfare in Jesus' name. Today, that is not the topic of my message today. That is not the subject of my message today. Today, we are going to talk about the wages of sin. And I know that nobody wants their sin to, very few people honor their sin being addressed. For some reason, the people of God, even Christians, we don't want our sins addressed. Amen. But we need to realize today that there is sin, and sin has to be addressed. Because after all, it is sin. It is the sin and the failure of us to relinquish sin and renounce sin that take people to hell. Amen. It is not, God doesn't take people to hell. We take ourselves there because we refuse to renounce the sin that's in our lives, our sinful lifestyles. Amen. So today I'm going to use for a foundational scripture, Hebrews 12 and 1. where God tell us to lay aside every weight and the sin that does so easily beset us, and to run with patience the race that he has set before us, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. I want us to look very carefully here at this scripture, Hebrews 12 and 1. When he said lay aside, that means you is understood here. You lay aside. God is not going to do it for us. Why? Because he has given us the power and the ability. It's our responsibility to lay our sins aside. It is our responsibility to lay our weights aside, the things that does so easily beset us. And we know that sin is a weight that does easily beset us. And a weight is anything that impedes or hinder us. When as I was preparing my message, the Lord reminded me of King Saul. You know, when God told Saul that he was going to give him his enemies, give his enemies over into his hands. God had remembered how the Amalekites had what they had done to Saul when they was coming out of Egypt, when Israel was coming out of Egypt on their way to the promised land. And so after centuries, God said to Saul, after Saul became the king of Israel, he said, I remember what the Amalekites did to you. So how many of you know that we have some Amalekites, and God remember what our enemy does to us. He does not forget. And God will revenge us of our adversaries, just like he did the Israelites. Amen. And when God said to Saul, I'm going to avenge you of your enemies today. I want you to go into the Amalekite army, and I want you to destroy everything. Man, woman, boy, girl, everything that breathes, animals, I'm going to give them over into your hands. But I need you to destroy everything. But we all know the story about what Saul did. Instead of Saul going in and destroying all the Amalekites, king first, King Ahab first, what he did, he went in and he spared the weak things. He spared the things that, he spared all the things that brought him pleasure. Amen. He spared all the things that he wanted to keep. And then he destroyed the things that didn't mean that much. Amen. And this is what we do right now. When God tells us to lay aside every sin and the weight that does so easily beset us, we only destroy those things that don't bring us pleasure. We destroy the little weak things, you know, but the things that bring us pleasure, the things that we enjoy doing, we keep those things alive. Amen. But God is saying, I need you to destroy it all. I need you to lay aside every weight. I need you to lay aside every sin, that thing that does so easily beset you, that thing that keep you from growing, that thing that keep you from maturing in me, that thing that keep you and hinder your relationship with me. I want you to destroy it. Amen. So if we are not growing, there is a reason that we are not growing. If we are remaining spiritual midgets, there's a reason why we are remaining spiritual midgets. And the number one reason is sin. Sin in our lives, because we refuse to lay aside the things that hinder us, the things that impede our walk with God, the things that hinder our growth, the things that hinder our maturity. Amen. Now, let's look here at Romans 6:23 that says, for the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. That means one thing, people of God, we're going to be compensated for our sins. Amen. That's what wages mean. We're going to be compensated for our sins. And the sad part about all of this is the compensation for sin is death. Amen. Complete, utterly, total separation from God. And we cannot afford to be separated from God. But God has told us that the wages of sin is death. The gift of God is eternal life. So it is time for us to lay aside the weights. Whatever it is that's in your life that's hindering your relationship with God. It doesn't matter if you have to walk away from your best friend. If they are not going where God is taking you. If they refuse to go where God is taking you. Sometimes you have to pronounce a benediction over your best friend. You have to pronounce a benediction. I don't care if it's a family member. You have to pronounce a benediction. If they are hindering your walk with God, if they are impeding your walk with God, it is time to say goodbye. Glory to God. Because God is saying, lay it aside. Whatever the problem is, lay it aside. Whatever the sin is, lay it aside. If we are going to do business with God, We're going to have to lay aside everything that is hindering our spiritual growth. Glory to God. And our relationship with God. A perfect example of the sin that's in our lives that people refuse and have a hard time, a difficult time laying aside is the sin of unforgiveness. God impressed that upon me, which is the inability to release someone, to cancel someone's debt. Amen. I tell you, I never ran across so many people who are struggling with unforgiveness in their lives. Something that someone did to them years and years, 15, 20 years ago, and they can't seem to release that person. They can't seem to free that person. Amen. That is a trick of the devil, because God has given us the ability to forgive everyone. There's no temptation taking us but such as coming to man. God has granted us the power and the ability to overcome the sin of unforgiveness. Amen. That sin will take us to hell quicker than anything else. Because many times we think we have a relationship with God, but because we are holding this sin of unforgiveness in our hearts, we cannot be who God has called us to be. We need to examine ourselves today, people of God. We need to do an inventory of our lives today and to see if there's any unforgiveness, any bitterness in our heart, any hatred, any anger towards someone else in our hearts that we need to release and let go so that we can live, so that we can mature, so that we can be the people of God that He has caused us to be. We will never grow. We will never be the people of God that He has caused us to be as long as we are holding unforgiveness in our heart. Unforgiveness is just like a poison. We drink it and we expect the other person to die. Amen. When in fact, we are the ones who are dying. We are the ones, glory to God, who are dying from the poison of unforgiveness. Amen. So we are being compensated and separated from God because of the sin of unforgiveness. God said, lay it aside. Lay it aside. I know I'm talking to someone out there today because I run across people, I'm being connected with so many people. And this, when I do deliverance, even at my church, when I do deliverance, the first thing the Lord shows me is this person is holding unforgiveness. They're holding bitterness in their hearts. And this is why they have not been able to be set free. Okay, many times people are going on trying to do the work of God, but they're holding unforgiveness in their heart. They love God. They love the ministry, but they cannot be set free as long as they're holding unforgiveness in their heart. Amen. Let's look here at Psalm 66 and 18, which says, if I regard iniquity in my heart, and iniquity, regarding something in our hearts, is the fact that we know it's there, but we're not doing anything to remove it. Amen. If I regard, if I hold, if I cherish these things in my heart, he said, the Lord will not hear me. How many of you know that we need God to hear us? We need God to hear our prayers, our intercession. Glory to God. Our prayers concerning other people. You know, when we're interceding on behalf of our family members, our unsaved loved ones, we need God to hear our prayers. We need God to intervene and do something to answer our prayers. But if we are regarding iniquity, if we are cherishing that thing in our heart, unforgiveness, God won't even hear us when we pray. And we are being so deceived. How many of us are praying? How many of us are laying hands on the sick? How many of us are casting out demons? How many of us are prophesying, but yet we're holding unforgiveness in our heart? That means one thing, that God is not hearing us. He's not honoring our prayers. He's not honoring the fact that we're laying hands on the sick. God is not honoring our prophecies. Amen, because we are holding the sin of unforgiveness in our heart. We have to realize, people of God, God has a standard for us to go by. God has a standard for us to live by. And until we raise up and begin to live according to God's standards, we will never be the people of God that He has called us to be. God wants us to grow in our relationship with Him. He wants us to grow and not be spiritual babies. Amen. Peter told us to desire the sincere milk of the word that we may grow. The truth of God's word. And the problem with God's people today, we don't want to accept the truth. Amen. This is why Paul said to Timothy, preach the word. In other words, preach the truth. It doesn't matter if we are stepping on people's toes. It doesn't matter if we are offending them. The truth has got to be told, people of God. God rebuked in the book of Isaiah. I was reading the other day how God rebuked his leaders and the priests in the book of Isaiah because of their failure. Glory to God, to teach the people the truth, to tell the people the truth. But they were deceiving the people. God is not pleased when we are deceiving the people and making them think or causing them to think that no matter how they live, they are still going to be blessed. The devil is a liar. God said, get rid of the sin. Lay that sin aside. Amen. And run with patience the race that he has given us. Looking unto Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith. Let's look here at Ephesians 4:32, where God says, be kind to one another. Be tenderhearted toward one another, forgiving one another as Christ has forgiven us. And this is the one thing that we seldom think about, how God forgave us. Amen. And as long as we live upon the face of this earth, we are at some point in our lives, people of God, we are going to need forgiveness. But if we have not forgiven others, if we have not found it in our hearts to be able to forgive others for what they have done to us, the hurt, the pain that they have caused in our lives, it doesn't matter what it is. Somebody may have been molested. You still have to forgive that person. You cannot hold that bitterness. You cannot hold unforgiveness in your heart against that person. Because as long as we hold this bitterness and unforgiveness and this anger in our hearts, God cannot forgive us for any of our sin. Amen. And we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. As long as we live in this flesh, people of God, we're going to be saying things. We're going to be doing things. We're going to be thinking things that we're going to need forgiveness for. But God is saying here, if we fail to forgive others, then he will not forgive us. How many of us need forgiveness today? I don't know about you, but every morning I get up, I'm asking God to forgive me for the sins of omission, the things that I should have done that I didn't do. Forgive me for the sins of commission, the things that I did that I know I should not have done, but I willfully done it anyway. I willfully sinned against God. The evil thoughts that came across my mind, glory to God, is something that we should always be repenting and asking God to forgive us for. Glory to God. So I admonish you today, take this message to heart and lay aside whatever it is, the sin of unforgiveness. Lay it aside. Lay aside every weight that impedes your walk with God, that hinders your relationship with God, that hinders your prayer, hinders God from hearing and answering your prayer. Lay it aside. It's not worth. Any of us is not worth holding on to. Amen. Let's look here at Matthew 18, verses 21 through 22. God is telling us here, as we forgave men, if we forgive men not their trespasses, then God, who is our Heavenly Father, will not forgive us our trespasses. You know, that's something to think about. If we do not forgive men, then God will not forgive us. You know, in the book of Hebrews also, God tells us to come boldly to the throne of grace, to obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Glory to God. How can we go boldly to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need when we are holding unforgiveness and bitterness and anger in our hearts? Amen. When we go before God, when we go to the throne room to obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need, there's a way that we have to approach God's throne. Glory to God. And that way is having no unforgiveness in our hearts. No anger, no bitterness toward our sister, our brother in our hearts. Amen. Glory to God. So I admonish you today. Begin to seek God. The Holy Spirit is there to inform us. The Holy Spirit is there to show us. The Holy Spirit is there to bring to our memory the things that's in our hearts that's not of God. Amen. That's why God sent the Holy Spirit. He's there to teach us. He's there to guide us. He's there to lead us. Amen. He's there to perfect us. The Holy Spirit will show us those areas in our lives where we need to just go before God and cry out to him for forgiveness. He will show us those areas in our lives where we need forgiveness. He will show us those areas in our lives where we need to forgive others. Amen. You don't forgive your pastor for something that maybe he didn't speak to you two Sundays ago. His mind was on something else. His mind was on the work of God, and he didn't speak to you. You're not going back to church because you are upset, you're angry because the pastor did not acknowledge you. Don't allow the enemy to rob you of your blessings because of the spirit of unforgiveness, the sin of unforgiveness. Amen. Glory to God. So I admonish you today, examine yourselves carefully to see if there's any sin, any bitterness in your heart against anyone. I tell you, people of God, we need our prayers to be heard and answered today. We need to be able to go boldly to the throne room to obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Therefore, we need to lay aside every weight, every sin that does so easily beset us, that thing that hinders us, that thing that impedes our walk with God. Glory to God. Don't let the devil deceive you into thinking that you have a relationship with God when you don't. We're still, when we are holding unforgiveness in our heart, we're walking around just a lukewarm sinner. We are walking around, having just a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. We can't afford to do this in this last hour. God is looking for real people. He's looking for people who are able, glory to God, to come boldly to his throne to obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Glory to God. I pray today that this message has been of some benefit to you. Glory to God. Whatever you do, remember to lay it aside. Lay it aside. God has done all that he's going to do. When he sent Jesus down the cross for us, when he sent Jesus to shed his precious blood for us, to make us overcomers, to give us the power to be able to lay aside and to overcome all the work of the enemy. He's done all that he's going to do. Now the ball is in our court. God said, I've given you the responsibility now. I've given you the power to lay these sins aside. Glory to God. I want you to pray about it. I want you to think about it. And I want you to be a doer of the word of God and not just a hearer only. Until next time, I'm your host, Evangelist Savannah Spears, saying God bless you.
Break every chain. Woo! To break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. There is power.
Come on. Come on, you declare it.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
God bless you, and thank you once again for watching Setting the Captives Free broadcast. I'm your host, Evangelist Savannah Spears. God bless you.
Break every chain. Break every chain.
Come on, say it to me.
Break every chain.
What's up, everybody? This is your girl, Vicki Winans, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Hi, everybody. I'm telling you, everything that happened to me that was good, God did it. I'm Evelyn Turrentine, AG, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Pastor D. Alexander Bullock, the Preachers of Detroit, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Bishop Edgar Vann of Second Ebenezer Church in Detroit, Michigan, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, I'm Bernadette Stannis. You know me best as Thelma from the TV show Good Times. And you are watching Bell Global Network.
What's up, everybody? This is your girl, Vicky Winans, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Hi, everybody. I'm telling you, everything that happened to me that was good, God did it. I'm Evelyn Turrentine, AG, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Pastor D. Alexander Bullock, the Preachers of Detroit, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Bishop Edgar Vann of Second Ebenezer Church in Detroit, Michigan, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, I'm Bernadette Stannis. You know me best as Thelma from the TV show Good Times. And you are watching Bell Global Network.